Welcome back to Let's Play Enderal. Forgotten Stories Blind. Welcome to the extra sick and coughing. No, the 200th episode. Special huge episode going to the arena. Reminds me of the other game I'm playing right now, Elder Scrolls Arena. Now, do I have this selected? Yes. Okay.
My, you look as though you have a kind heart.
I look that way, huh? Hmm. Now, I don't know if this is just a series of fights and then that's it.
Keep walking.
Come to bed. Talk to Rasha.
That's Rasha.
Sun child, aren't you?
Oh, fucking Christ.
I've heard about those yellow coats invading this country. Free peoples of Nerin. I'm guessing for once those surface snobs are wishing for the safety of these caves.
I don't know who the hell's talking. Anyway, I've been putting this off for quite a while because, well, I'm not really a close combat character. I can't take a lot of hits and such, but I think I've improved with that. In various ways. Because now I have a better summons. I have a spirit that can actually be with me in these circumstances. Not sure if the,
just remember your training. You can do this.
Thank you. I was waiting for those words of encouragement. I'm not sure if I could summon him before, but in any case, he's more powerful now. What I want to do...
Money on the Eterna.
Okay, so there's... I have that out for what it is. Do I have any petty? No. I think we'll be fine, at least for that. I know we're coming across two enemies at once. So what I'm thinking about doing is paralyzing one of them. Tomato, all I have is cheap.
Bloody vermin.
Summoning what I need to summon. And basically just going to town. I'm not too... I don't know. I don't have a very good look on my outcome here, but we'll try our best. So I got that, and then... That's not what I want. That's my summon. And you know what I'm also gonna do? Talk to her. See how we do. He's around here somewhere.
Yes.
You got guts walking around with all that stuff down here.
Thanks. All right, let's get started.
Bold words. All right, then go downstairs and warm up. I'll tell you when we're ready.
Bold words.
Mesdames and messieurs, a cordial welcome to the Dust Pit. You know who I am.
I'm trying to summon him.
I know who you are, and above all, I know why you are here today. Because you want to see a fight. Today, two familiar faces will fight a rookie who you've already grown to love. The twins against the mysterious warrior only known as The Nameless One!
Nameless One.
It is a battle to the death. A battle about gold and blood. Now enough of the words. Time to give you what you've all been waiting for. Warriors, fight!
So let me get a strike off. Whoops. That's it? I hit it once. I hit him once. I barely got a chance to do anything. Defeat the twins. Receive the reward, alright. And I messed up, I forget my key bindings and everything else. Gotta collect my reward. Hold on 1 second. Chunko cheese. Yeah, cheese wheel. Alright, stand by, guys. Okay, just in case there's a second... Well, I guess in this case, third? Fourth? I don't know, we did one or two before, way back. I can't believe my my companions did basically all the work for me. I don't even know if I successfully paralyzed that guy. I have to watch because I just hit him and I ran. So yeah, I think my chances are pretty good here. So I'm gonna choose another paralyze. Potion of paralysis. Or poison of paralysis. Sorry about that, we keep getting interrupted, but I think we're good now. And what did I want to do? Oh yeah, save. Hi.
Hmm? What do you want?
My share? I fought and I won. And I won, in case you didn't notice.
Ah, sure. Sorry. I was... elsewhere.
Elsewhere?
Here's your share.
That's on Tamriel. And that rhymes. Why what? Because of the Eterna?
Well deduced, detective.
What's it about? What does he want from you? I'm a little kind of in the dark here because we stalled on this quest like forever. What does the Eterna want from you?
His shadow tribute, which my esteemed father, who rediscovered his juvenile spite in his last years, refuses to pay. Hmm. Which in return means that the nice guy who just paid me a visit will send us some of Relata's goons to either set fire to our establishment, or send my father onto the Eternal Paths a couple of years earlier, if I don't think of something.
What's the Shadow Tribute?
Protection money. If you want to stay alive down here, you have to pay.
Hmm. Maybe I could take care of that guy for you?
Oh, you have no idea how the wind blows down here, do you?
Stinkily?
Thanks for the offer, but no. Only an utter idiot would take on the Ralaim.
Raising my hand. Complete idiot here. Hello. Any idea when the next fight will happen, then?
2 or 3 days, give or take.
Oh.
Oh, I know you'd love to jump right back in. But if we start doing battles every bloody minute, the crowd will lose interest. And money.
Hmm.
Just swing by in a couple of days, all right? You'll get your fight.
Wait for the next battle? So I'm literally just sitting around for 2 days, okay? Staring at her.
You can do this.
Just in case this one kills me. Also, my stuff wore off, right? Probably.
Should have placed my money on the Eterna.
That's all you got?
The other guy mentioning the Eterna.
Look at that. You have a talent for showing up when you're needed. You know that? There's a fight coming up, and I want you to participate.
Oh, goody. Who am I fighting?
Ger Halnan. He's been fighting for a while now. A brute in heavy armor. With a couple of, how should I say, special techniques he picked up in his homeland, Erezil.
Wonderful.
I won't lie. He'll be a tough nut to crack.
Hmm. Fine by me. Let's get started.
Aren't you eager? You know the drill. Go downstairs and warm up. The fight will take place in a couple of hours.
Couple of hours? So I guess a couple hours later.
Madam and may sirs, a cordial welcome to the dust pit. You know who I am. I know who you are. And above all, I know why you are here today. Because you want to see a fight? Today, there is something special on the menu. Or should I say, something savage? Because this is a word that best describes the beast our still undefeated rookie must stand his ground against. Madam and may sirs, I present Ger Halnan, the Berserker of the Steppes, versus the Nameless One. Shed some blood, warriors!
Or enough of them. Oh! He resisted! There he goes. Not bad. This time I actually got to fight. I'm gonna stuff some cheese in my mouth here. My summon is still down there, just like watching the fight. So my Starling Navigator spirit uses frost spells, that's interesting. Don't hit the wall too hard, you'll break your hand.
A sun child, aren't you?
Oh god.
I've heard about those yellow.
Saving that victory?
This country.
Not bad. I have to hand it to you. You're really starting to impress me. I didn't think you'd stand a chance against old Ger.
Lasted 10 seconds.
But, he knew the risks. Here's your share. Come back in 2 days or so.
$350 experience, okay. Wait for all these battles. Okay, wait for the next battle. I will silently stare at you for 2 days.
Yes?
Yeah, I want to fight. You ready?
Hi, we are. This time it'll be exciting.
This time?
The Ringmaster plans to pair you with Raga Shadowclaw.
Who's that? Should I know her? How do I even know the gender of this person?
No, but you will soon. She's an alchemist. Small tip from my side. Don't let her tender appearance fool you. You'll see why.
Hmm. Actually still have to prepare myself.
All right, I'll wait. But don't take too long.
I won't. And...
What do you want?
I'm still not confident against for my odds here, even though we've been doing so well. I want to fight against Raga.
Aren't you eager? You know the drill. Go downstairs and warm up. The fight will take place in a couple of hours.
There's a lot of fights here.
This is the fourth battle of the mysterious.
I have to resummon. Yes, my ghost is here.
One, but will it also be the
fourth
last
battle?
Because
oh, so only fought one battle before?
We picked a special treat for her to feast on.
Oh, goody.
Madame, and may sirs, you came for blood.
Oh.
And you shall have it.
I forgot something. And this is so unrealistic. Oh my, this sounds different. Okay. Whoa, what happened? Oh my god, what? Turned into a werewolf? These guys are strong. Oh, hello. We weren't able to search anyone before. They turned into like ribs and stuff. Glittering Shaman Amulet increases the duration time of the transformation of wolf blood potions by 45 seconds. Oh. So that's what she was doing as an alchemist. Using the Chimicum potions and such. Effects only potions brewed while this effect is active. This is heavy. That's not. It doesn't give that much back. Spell Tome Spectral Chest? Rank 2. Opens a magical chest with a base capacity of 30 points, which is increased by 1 for every skill level and mentals. Wow. Don't think I know that one. I did get hurt. I didn't get hit a lot for being hurt that much, I don't think. Well, then again, some of it was me draining my life essence to hurt that person. You really gotta be determined to kill somebody if you're gonna hurt yourself to kill them. What's this, book? Wait, center. Is it actually books? Or is it consumables? I forget. Otherwise it'd be under Spell Tome Spectral Chest. Cool. So now I can use a chest? So many fights, so little money. All, okay. I'm curious about this thing. So I can just keep stuff in there. That's cool. But can only hold 30 points? What is that, like 30 pounds? Oh, okay. Current loading capacity, 48 pounds. Alright. Can't keep much in there, but could be helpful for keeping a few little things in there that might be weighing us down. Fucking crush you. Alright. In case there's another. Paralysis and... Yeah, now we will charge this thing. Does it need anything? Wait. No, not really.
Just remember your training. You can do this.
So the next thing I'm gonna put is the I have it on still. Okay, good.
Look who's back! Not bad, not bad.
Thanks.
I was expecting you to pee your pants after she did that little trick of hers. But no. You kept your cool as usual.
That was a good trick. I thought she was dead.
Sure you don't want to start working as a mercenary? You could make more money that way. Either way, here's your pay.
I kind of am working as a mercenary sometimes. It's 450 gold and experience. That's interesting.
Yes.
I'm guessing you're tired of hearing me ask this, but any estimate on when the next fight will take place?
I had hoped you'd ask that. I do. And this time, you're in for a real challenge.
Oh boy. Another shapeshifter?
No. If you're man enough, you'll fight the beast tonight.
Woman enough. I am no man. The beast?
Aye, the pride of the pit. And the good thing about it, even if you hack it to shreds, all we need to do is give it some elixir and have our necromancer stick it back together, and it's as good as new. I won't lie, though. It'll be hard this time, and chances are you won't make it out alive. If you do make it, though, it'll be worth your time.
Okay, so I'm fighting this thing once, right? Or you're gonna resurrect it and bring it back for me to fight again? I don't have a chance to ask that, really. You're resurrecting that creature? What is this, Sinistra?
Something like that, aye. But let's not dwell on the details, shall we?
Details. Alright, I need to prepare myself.
Alright, I'll wait. But don't take too long.
I never do. Just need to renew my shield here. Is it renewed or is it just gone? Let me just see. Divine shield. Okay, it's on. I don't know why sometimes it doesn't show up in the corner and sometimes it does. So we still have our ghost. Okay. And I'm gonna save.
Yes.
I will fight the beast.
Thought so. Well then.
Defeat the monster.
But can the nameless
oh God.
Also oppose the beast that's been soaking this soil in blood for decades.
I can oppose. I don't know.
We shall see. Unleash the beast.
Ghost is here. And let me take my weapon out. Weapon out. Was my weapon. 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 I can't take my weapon out. I can't even move. Let me move. Oh. What the hell's going on here? What? Who the hell are you?
Hey, what are you doing? Get out of the ring now!
My rightful kill.
Let's see you dance.
What?
Nameless one.
Unknown person.
Enemy!
Oh. Whoa! I'm like almost dead anyway. Take an exclusive one.
Die!
Wait, what am I doing? Hold up. Wrong button. Yikes! Wrong button. I could have been a contender.
Enemy.
Oh. Now I'm really not prepared. I think I hit my... He is good. And I'm kind of out of practice. I haven't played this for a while. Anyway. Poison paralysis, right? I did use it. Switch. Wrong. Switch.
Good. That's it.
The guy just wants to talk now?
Let's talk.
Wow.
Fair enough. This is better.
You teleported us?
Forgive me my dramatic entrance.
You almost killed me. And technically you did kill me. I don't want to continue where you left off, not just yet. I see a potion back there, though. Is this the... we're in the fish hatchery, I think? Or is this the old waterworks? What in the blazes was that? Why did you interrupt the fight?
I was just about to explain. I'm Tharael Naris, voice of the Father.
The Father?
I've been watching you for a while now because I'm looking for someone with your set of skills. And, our little encounter down in the pit erased the last doubts I had about you.
You should still doubt it. Still. Even in continuity, you almost killed me. The voice of the Father?
That accent. You're an outlander, aren't you? Shit. Does that mean I have to explain who the Ralaim is to you?
I have a rough idea. Pretty much this, but I don't know if I want to piss the guy off. You're some kind of guild that's controlling the Undercity, right?
Right. The Ralata is more than a bunch of criminals, though. But we'll get there. Regarding your original question, the voices are the military arm of the Ralata. I'm sure you've seen some of us before. We come into play when a matter needs a strong hand to resolve itself.
So this was supposed to be some kind of test?
Indeed. Let me get straight to the point. I want to hire you for a mission.
Do I look like a mercenary? Probably do.
Well, you look like someone willing to slaughter other people in front of a gawking crowd for a handful of coins. At least that's what you did down there. Don't get me wrong, I don't judge. The pit fighters know what they're getting themselves into. But after what I saw you do down there, I concluded that you're willing to do a lot of things if the pay is right. Or am I wrong?
Pay is good. No, you're not wrong.
Well then.
So, tell me about this mission then.
Well, actually, it's simple. I want your help in killing someone.
Can't do it yourself. Oh, you're just gonna stand over there? That's a rancid one. Did you kill this rat too? Where's this go? Marketplace?
The Father.
I wanna see it was over there. So, what, your leader? The head of the Ralata?
Their leader. Not mine.
Not yours.
When I was 6 years old, the Ralata abducted me and a dozen other children. That is, they bought us. Shagun, the old cunt who owned our orphanage. She sold us like cattle.
The Ralata abducted you? They abducted children?
Us, and over the years at least a dozen more. And we all came from the same orphanage. The refuge.
The refuge.
I have no idea what they did to us. I remember nothing.
So you were an orphan?
Yes.
That's quite an explanation. Okay, wait, did you just say that the woman who ran the orphanage sold you? Why did she do that? Let me guess, for money?
Why? Probably because the Father shoved an ingot of gold up her ass for every child she sold.
Right.
But the flesh maggots got her a while ago, so she took her reasons to the grave with her.
Just desserts, I'd say. Why would the Father abduct children?
That's the big question, isn't it? At first I thought it was about child trafficking. You know, tender little knaves and girls for rich bastards. Arx bigwigs. Yet now I've come to the conclusion that it must have been about science. Experiments.
Experiments? So, the Ralata conducted experiments on you?
Only the Father. As I said, I'm pretty sure you have the wrong idea about them. The Ralata doesn't see itself as a guild of murderers, but as a faith, a sect. cults, in other words. The blackmailing, the shadow tax, is how they finance their little community.
And what do they believe in?
That the physical body is the worst thing that ever happened to man. It's a hole that needs to transcend.
Really?
But we digress. If we're to work together, you'll soon have some rogue cultists telling you all this shit anyway.
You should talk to the guy and his, apprentice that just... He wanted to, live on inside a starling construct. I see. But you're alive. Does that mean you were somehow able to flee? Well, no, he stayed in the Ralaim and he's, like, been biding his time until he could hire someone like me to destroy them. This way it doesn't blow his cover in case I'm not, you know, successful in doing so. He continues on surviving, more or less.
Kind of. After the father was done with us, he simply disposed of our corpses. This is also the first memory I have of that time after the abduction. Waking up in a pile of dead bodies. I don't know exactly, but I must have been somewhere between 12 to 14 years old. Still half a child, in other words. As you can imagine, I was a mess for the first few moons after that. Once I was able to think somewhat straight again, I looked for help in the upper city. Of course, the guards didn't believe a word of what I said and sent me right back down into the caverns.
Right, exactly. An infiltrator. Wait, you told the guards, or whoever above, that the Ralaim conducts experiments on children and they didn't do anything?
No. And frankly, it doesn't surprise me. I'm sure hundreds of ragged kids from the Undercity had come to them before, telling them horror stories about how much they suffered down there, only to get a bed and some food. Also, as you may have figured out by now, the Order doesn't have any power down here.
Right.
The Ralaim controls the caves, and that's how it will stay.
There's just too much of you to mount some kind of invasion of the Undercity, if they even cared to do so, which they probably wouldn't. Well, I'm not sure what to say about your whole story. It's truly horrible.
Many things are horrible. Still, they happen.
That's true. So you're you're a voice of the Father, but you intend to kill him, so you're some kind of infiltrator?
Correct. Let's put it this way. I came to realize that no matter how much I cursed and cried, nobody would come to my help. So I decided to take matters into my own hands. I told myself how to survive and how to fight. And years later, I entered the dustpit for the first time. One of the voices saw how well I could fight and offered me to study the Ralaim.
The Ralaim? Yeah.
Their codex, their holy scripture. Written by the Father himself. I shaved my head and became a scion, the lowest rank.
Well, nobody recognized you? Not even the Father? Well, I guess you were a lot younger then.
The Father doesn't bother with most Ralaim, especially not with the scions. Also, when they discarded me, I was still a child. Now, I'm a man.
No kidding. How long ago was that, your initiation?
8 years ago.
So you're out for revenge?
Revenge? Yes. I want this monster to pay for what he did to me and the others. And I want to make sure that it will never hurt anyone again. Ever. One of the core beliefs of the Ralaim concerns the Day of Transcendence. It's the day when every Ralaim who's ever proven him or herself worthy leaves their body to continue existing as an immortal, immaterial being. And they also believe that this day is imminent, since the Father found a way to achieve transcendence for himself and for his lambs. In the weeks to come, it will set out an expedition to the Frostcliff Mountains.
Oh, just came from
since
there.
Since this expedition will be an extremely dangerous undertaking, he will bring along almost a dozen of the best mercenaries available. You will be one of them. And together, We will kill the father.
Huh. More? Wait. So you're telling me all this just because you saw me fight?
I'm telling you this because I need someone who knows how to kill. Better than the usual cutthroat you find down here. And you seem to be that someone. Also, there's something about you. I can't say what, but I feel as though you're the right person for the job. Let's leave it at that.
What kind of expedition?
Well, the Relata spent the last 2 years excavating an old temple that apparently was lost in the glacier for centuries. Now, according to the father, this is where we'll find the key to achieve transcendence, but that's about all I know.
Sounds like a very risky plan. What's in it for me?
Well, I can pay you 400 pennies now, and 800 more once the father is dead. Also, think of all the riches that we'll find in the temple itself, or in the Relata's treasure chambers.
True.
It will be worth it. You can trust me on that.
Plus, I have to explore everything anyway, so hopefully we're not going somewhere we've already been, but Enderal doesn't really do that. I mean, anywhere that's like a quest, I probably wouldn't be able to get into. What's stopping me from telling the Relata that you're a traitor?
Well, let's put it this way. I took precautions. If you don't have the guts to help me, your choice, but believe me, if you do try to backstab me, you'll regret it.
Mm-hmm. How do we convince the father to hire me as a mercenary?
By doing something that impresses him. As you can imagine, the Relata already has its stock of cell swords they rely on. But if we do something that impresses the father or the first seer, it might be enough to convince him to hire you. Look, I know how shaky it sounds, but it's our best bet.
Well, there's my successes in the pit.
Are you with me or not?
Yes, I'll help. If what you say about the father is true, he needs to face justice.
Absolutely. Meet me at the Wailing Tree, two hours
from now.
What's his name?
Tharael.
Here.
Wailing Tree?
Just help you get back to the Undercity in case you need to return to the surface before our meeting. Stay safe.
Give me a scroll. Teleport to the Undercity Barracks. Three of them. Qalian? Meet Tharael at the arena. Kalian's last smile. I just read about Qalian in the Butcher of Arcs series. Where are we? Oh, we're in the corpse pit. Yeah, I've been here. I mean, some of these things might have come back, but there's no reason to, So, he gave me teleport to the marketplace? Or the barracks? I'll hold on to him. Welcome back, my friend.
Oh, stupid shit. Oh.
It's kind of just thinking about using the one of the scrolls, but we're right here.
You're not one of the mercenaries, are you? Word has it they're hiring again. Give them a white berth if I were you.
You would, huh? I don't know what to expect here, so...
There you are. Ready?
Before we leave, what's the story behind that tree?
Tree? Oh, yeah, sure. The people down here call it the Weeping Tree.
Oh, that's what you
they
mentioned.
They believe that the Black Guardian, once a year, fulfills one of the wishes they write onto these notes. Superstitious nonsense, of course. They might as well send their wishes to the Blue Island Coalition.
Been a while since I got a knowledge check. Well, sometimes hope alone can help.
Maybe. Ready to set out?
Oh, he didn't like that. You're not wearing the garments of the Ralaim. Why is that?
What do you think? Because we don't want to draw any attention. If somebody sees me walking around with you, it won't be the end of the world. But I don't want to cause unnecessary problems.
Can I just... I want to go look, see if there's notes down there. Alright, what's the plan?
First, the question. Have you ever heard of the Knights of the Blind Daughters?
No.
A massacre that took place 20 years ago. It was at the farmer's coast, around midsummer. The farmers had just put out the lights after a long day's work. Suddenly, shrouded figures showed up out of nowhere, with steel masks covering their faces. They broke into the houses, and killed anybody who dared to stand in their way.
The Petrified, I think
well,
they're called?
Merely wreaked havoc on most of the farms. Any family with a daughter between 12 and 16 winters was less lucky. All in all, these masked people took 10 daughters that night and carried them away. They were found 1 week later. They lay on the Penny Road, mutilated with their eyes sewn shut. One girl each mile.
The girls are found. I thought he was telling me the guys are found, man. And then the guard didn't intervene at all?
They tried. But the few farm boys who were there in time stood no chance.
Yes.
These masked attackers were assassins. As deadly as the Petrified and as brutal as Lost Ones.
They weren't the Petrified, but they're as deadly as the Petrified. Okay. But why, though? Why sew their eyes shut and leave them there?
To this very day, no one knows. However, there are theories. Do the names the Black Lieber and J.L. Tannison ring a bell? The Butcher of Ark.
The Black Libra, no. But the Butcher of Ark, Tannison, wasn't he some kind of serial killer? Who then took his own life? Or did he take his own life at the end?
Yes.
You spoiled the last
thing
book for
is,
me.
In this book he left behind, Tannison claims to have been part of a cult called the Black Libra.
Oh.
Even nowadays there are still scholars that deny its existence.
I'm not up to that.
According
one.
To Tannison, they see themselves as some kind of counterbalancing power. They make sure that malice and sin, they don't gain the upper hand in this world, and that the scales of good and evil thus stay in balance.
Oh, really? So that was him that did it? And that's why he murdered those girls? It really doesn't make any sense.
Well, this is where it gets bizarre. Normally, the Libra only kills people who have already sinned. Tyrants, rapists, murderers, and so on.
Right.
Which is also why the attack on the farmer's coast didn't make any sense, and still doesn't for most people today. However, the father has a theory.
So the father's an expert on the Black Libra, too?
Well, he does have an avid interest in them. Let's put it this way. He has dug up every little bit of information that there is. But we'll come to that later.
Very curious as to who this father really is, what does he look like? I'm sure we'll find out at the end of all this. So what's his theory then? Why did the Black Libra murder those girls? Because they murdered too many bad guys? And then they had to, you know, put the balance, you know? Balance in all things. They had to balance out, kill some innocents to even the scales, as it were?
According to the father, the Black Libra chooses their sinners through the dreams of some kind of holy child.
holy child.
The dreams are interpreted by the Libra's priests, who extract the names and faces of evildoers from them.
Right, well, I'm saying nothing because those poor little girls are not evildoers.
However, the child doesn't just see people who have already sinned.
Children.
She also sees evil in its inception. Thus, the Libra might decide to kill a boy before he becomes a tyrant, or a girl before she gives birth to a murderer.
Alright, now that's...
I know, it sounds insane, but that's what it is. But apparently the Libra fully believes in this principle. The child is omniscient.
Yeah, that's when you start to run into trouble. You know, if you went back in time and killed, you know, any, you know, evil dictator when they were a kid, I mean, yeah, you're stopping them from rising and become a dictator, but number one, someone else would, you know, could inevitably take their place. Number two, you're killing someone who's technically innocent at that point. Maybe instead of killing that person, maybe guide them towards, you know, I know it's a lot harder. And it's not guaranteed as killing someone they stay, usually they stay dead, but if you guide someone towards, you know, not wanting to rule people with an iron fist, it's always a good thing. So those girls had to die because the Libra believed they would give birth to murderers. Who's to say that this holy child is always right?
So it would seem, though according to the father, they wouldn't have just been ordinary murderers, but emissaries of the end. Whatever that may mean.
Oh. Emissaries of the end makes me think they have something to do with, the High Ones. They're helping the High Ones bring about the end of the world. So they kill 10 innocent girls and believe they're doing good.
Yes.
Okay. Okay, so just how does this relate to the Ralaim? Relate to the Ralaim, I like that.
Simple. The father believes that the Black Libra knows the secret to transcendence. This is why he's been studying Tennyson's books like a madman. Especially one in particular, in which he describes the initiation ritual he underwent to become one of their assassins. And I also think that this temple in the Frostcliff Mountains is somehow related to the Libra. Long story short, apparently the pages of Tennyson's original manuscript describing the initiation ritual in detail were forcefully torn out, and the father wants to find them.
Yeah. Well, you guys are spoiling the entire series for me. I'm only up to the Butcher of Ark Volume 6. There's four more volumes to go through, so I don't know what volume he joins this Libra cult. But yeah, you're completely spoiling the book for me. You should be ashamed of yourself. So you want me to find them, right?
Right. And I happen to know the only person who might be able to tell us their whereabouts. A man named Qalian.
Qalian? I thought it was Qalian. The Qalian from Tennyson's books? Qalian?
Correct. He was also an assassin of the Libra, and Tennyson's mentor.
Right.
In other words, an unscrupulous piece of shit that did nothing but murder people for decades, guilty, innocent alike. According to the father, he was also the one who orchestrated the Night of the Blind Daughters. However, that massacre seems to have been too much even for his rotten conscience to bear, because he left the Libra shortly thereafter. He took on a new identity. He's been living as a beggar in the Undercity ever since.
Really?
I saw him once. It's no wonder that nobody knows what kind of monster he is. He's gone completely insane. Drinks away every penny he gets his hands on. Exactly. If we bring them to the First Seer and I tell him how I couldn't have done it without you,
exactly,
he might consider hiring you for the expedition. That's the plan. Not the best one, certainly, but all we're getting.
It seems like I had a bunch of responses rolled into one. What if he doesn't hire me?
Then we'll need to improvise. Let's just hope it doesn't come to that.
What, am I gonna punch him until he does hire me? I mean, I've done that down here once. But that was a female. Alright, where do we find Qalian?
He currently lives in the communes. That is, if he isn't in some whore's bed in the Silver Cloud right now or getting hammered in the false dark.
Could be anyone.
I'll let you do the talking. It's unlikely that the first seer will find out, but the more you actually help me on this mission, the more convincing our little story will be. One more thing. Don't go easy on that scum. He might seem harmless now, but remember what he's done. And remember that those 10 mutilated girls on the Penny Road are just one more page in this man's book of sins.
Follow Tharael to the communal hut. Okay. I'll be right there. I want to take a look down here. Haha. Complete German. Here, have a penny.
Oh, thank you. You truly are a good person.
Found your English now, didn't you? Just one of these notes. Oh, I can't read them. Nope, I cannot read those notes. I think I've been down here, too. Yeah, this goes to the dustpan. Sod off. Yeah, I can't read this stuff. Okay.
Obulus, my dame, please. The Lord will redeem you for your kindness.
I just gave you an obulus. Alright, so let's go follow this guy. So we're actually going to meet Qalian, or Qalian, however the hell you say it. So just to, a little bit of background here, I've been reading the Butcher of Ark series. I've read 1 through 6. All of them are like 20-something minutes long to read. I have 4 more. I might find 4 more in this mission, because what the father's looking for pages of the last book or something? I'm not sure. So I hope not, because I've been enjoying spacing them out. It takes a while to read these, to go through these. It's good. It's really very well written, I must say. But yeah, it's just a lot of reading to read. The last book was like took me 29 minutes to read. Anyway, the whole thing about Jael Tanerson, the Butcher of Ark, is that he ended up killing some people. They weren't very nice people anyway, but he did completely butcher them. And that's when, at an inn, on the road to, I think it was in the Heartlands, the farmlands. Farmer's Coast. Yeah, in Farmer's Coast there's an ox, the Ox Tavern, Ox Head, or something like that. So he was staying there, and there were a couple guys who, you know, he got involved with them in a way, and then he wanted to do something to, he wanted to mess up their horses or something like that. He was playing a prank on them, because they basically were bullying him. He's a former priest, or he's still considering himself a priest, but no longer practicing. And, I think he started out by killing someone and then fled, or he was having crazy thoughts or something like that, and he fled, and then found himself there at the Ox, in the Ox Tavern or something like that. Anyway, he's trying to mess with their horses, give them something to make them drunk or pass out or something like that, and they caught him. And they started messing with him, and then Qalian showed up. Actually, I think he killed both of them? Or Qalian might have killed one of them and Jael killed the other. But yeah, then he became kind of Jael's mentor. And they went to Ark, and they went to the Undercity. And they went to the Silver Cloud, which is down here, is the actual place you can visit. And they rented or bought a couple girls, and they were chained up and drugged. Not completely sure what he, if they was for sexual purpose or he just when it's gonna kill them, torture them or something like that. But even Jael was kind of horrified by it and confronted Qalian. So not sure if it's Qalian. And I guess it's Qalian. And he attacked. The Butcher of Arak, Jael, attacked Qalian and didn't hurt him at all. And Qalian basically backhanded him and he went flying across and the room with that they were in. Hit the wall and passed out. And that was pretty much the end of book 6. So yeah, they're alike in certain ways, and I think Qalian knew more about Jael and Jael's murderous instincts than Jael knew himself. Very interesting books. Move on.
Come.
Well, one moment. You know what? Yeah. Throw that in.
A Sunchild, I bet you came to watch those fools cut their guts open in the dust pit.
I cut their guts open. Keep talking. So just running all the way back then. I still, there's a basement I think I need to go in. Oh, back here? Ooh, he's a big man, is that what you said? I guess he's kind of big.
Well, look at that. Our friend has a visitor.
A visitor? I want to get a good look at this guy. What am I looking for? Mage light.
Get out of here.
What?
I said, get out of here. We need 10 minutes.
That book.
Afterwards, you can fuck as many men as you want.
Oh.
I... Of course, my lord. At once.
Interesting.
Where is he? Was that really necessary?
Oh, I'll bring a bouquet of flowers next time.
You just like that too. Oh, it. Oh, that? That's Qalian? You sure that's him?
Yes.
You talk way too much, you know that? Why interesting?
Never mind. Look at him. Pissed like a rat. A miracle he could even get it up.
I don't need to know if he did or not. Do you want me to wake him up?
I sure as fuck don't want you to cuddle with him.
No.
And again, never forget what this man did. He may look pathetic, but that doesn't change the fact that he orchestrated the murder of 10 girls. Innocent girls.
Can you spare a moment? You're really tall. There's something I wanted to ask you.
What?
That went away quickly. Is it true that Ralaim controls the entire Undercity and not the Holy Order?
It is. Why?
How exactly does the Ralaim rule?
Well, actually, it's simple. Everybody who lives down here and earns money has to give a part of that to the Ralaim every month and get protection in return.
Protection from
this
yourselves?
This applies to everybody, from beggar to crime lord.
Wow. Getting knowledge. And what if they really have nothing to give? I mean, beggars don't really have much to give.
That's an exception.
And the Order doesn't have a problem with that?
On the contrary. The Order is quite happy with the way things are going down here.
Really?
They take care on the shiny surface, and the Ralaim take care of the stinking caves below.
Oh. So I don't have to think about it or deal with it, I get it. So how powerful is the Ralaim really, in terms of strike force?
You mean when it comes to killing cocky bandits and vatires?
Vatires?
Quite powerful. I don't think you find more skilled sinistropes or assassins anywhere else. Of course, in a fair duel with a keeper, most voices would probably end up in the dirt. But that's not how people fight down here.
No fair deal, huh? So now I've heard it pronounced three different ways. Vatires, Watires, and Vatires, I think he said? I'd like to know more about the Ralaim and their faith.
Why?
Because you should know your enemy?
Fine. I can give you the essentials, but beyond that, I can't be bothered. Ask.
Okay. How long has the Ralaim been around for?
Since the Father founded it, 400 years ago.
Okay. So the Father is 400 years old?
Correct.
Oh. How's that even possible? Not even Nina Aeterna lives that long.
Nobody knows. But I would guess it had something to do with his experiments.
Oh, right.
All those children's corpses must have been good for something, don't you think?
So, like, I wonder if he absorbed their essence or something like that. What does it mean to become a Ralaim?
Above all else, to leave your old life behind you. All contact is buried, all bridges burned. Most Ralaim call themselves orphans even if they once had a family. In other words, if you conscribe yourself to the Ralaim and his teachings are your new life and the Ralaim your new family. Everything you do, everything you think, everything you dream is subject to the goal of achieving transcendence. Liberation from the human body.
Kind of reminds me of that group in the Planescape Torment. The, I can't remember the name of them now. The, Wow, I'll have to put a annotation. Been a while since I played that game. So the Dustmen. Yeah, the Keepers? The Dusties? I think they're called the Dustmen. Yeah. What are your duties as a Ralaim? As a voice, especially.
This and that. Most of the time I'm busy reminding the residents of the Undercity to pay their shadow tax, and to make them feel the consequences if they don't.
What consequences? Let me guess. Pain? Severing of limbs? Death of loved ones? Things like that?
Anything from a clout to the ear to a knife between the ribs.
So you want to kill the Father for the good of the world, but you don't mind killing people for the Ralaim?
All right. Two things. First of all, I've killed no more than a handful of people for the Ralaim. And they weren't poor women with babes sucking at their teats, but scum, who knew the rules and thought they could play rebel. Believe me, it takes a lot for the Ralaim to order the death sentence for someone. They are criminals, yes, and they are led by a monster. But they are not stupid. If every misdemeanor were to be punished by decapitation, it wouldn't be long until there'd be a revolt in the Undercity.
True.
Secondly, nothing in life comes for free. If you think you can achieve something of relevance without compromising a part of yourself, then you're a fool. The death of the Father could be worth 100 dead cutthroats,
and I'd put arrows into each of their chests if it would get me any closer to my goal.
Gleeful outpours. Oh, you've got a point. Let me guess he'll like that.
You can trust me on one thing, though. Killing these people, it didn't come easy. And some of the things that I did to not lose my cover will haunt me to the grave. But you know what?
What?
Sad as it is, the world needs people like me. All these do-gooders who think they could fight evil without getting their hands dirty are self-righteous idiots. The monsters of this world, the murderers, the tyrants. You need to speak their language if you want to be a threat to them. Everything else is a delusion.
Right about that. You really gotta speak their own language. It's the only thing they understand. So if the Father is right and transcendence is imminent, why not just wait for him and the Ralaim to disappear?
That's a bloody stupid question.
Thank you.
Okay, let's assume for a moment that we don't intervene and kill the Father on the expedition. There are three possible scenarios to how this visit to the Room of Paintings would go down. Number one, it goes wrong and he and whoever follows him inside all die. This is the only case where you're right. Number two, he succeeds and actually manages to separate his mind from his body. Then we'd have a spectral murderer floating through the world possessing powers we can't even begin to imagine.
So he'd still be here.
Number three, the temple turns out to be a dead end and he returns to the Undercity. Then we might have missed the only chance to even get close enough to kill him. You get my point? It's too much of a risk to sit on our hands and hope scenario number one happens.
Right. Well, you definitely got a point there. For some reason, I assume transcendence would mean you're leaving your body and this world, this dimension, whatever.
What?
Wasn't there something else? No, okay. Oh. Oh, now I can get that. Mage Light Rank 2, which I used. Rancid, it's not even worth it. Cure Disease. Guess I'm stealing it from Qalian. Mage Light. Qalian backwards.
Yeah, who are you? Nylock is tired. Nylock needs sleep.
Nylock is not your name. You're Qalian.
Qalian? No, no. Qalian is dead.
He says Qalian.
You're talking to Nylock, his shadow. Why do you ask? Who are you?
His shadow. He says Qalian, so I was right. Shut up, I'm the one asking the questions.
Oh, of course. Nylock understands.
He likes Tharael liked it.
You.
That's why he liked it.
You remind him of Qalian when he still lived. So much anger in you. So much hatred. Qalian knew this feeling too well. This anger, this cold, rotten wrath. And then the dream came and showed him his calling. But he was so blind, he didn't see where the road led him. Only when those little flowers, corpses lay dead in the dust did he see. See what he had done. What do you become?
Talking about those
now
girls?
Now Qalian has been punished. He's dead, and Nylock deserves to suffer for eternity.
Huh. Now what's funny is that the Mage Light, I think, make his face even shadowier than... have more shadow on it than it would otherwise. Yeah. Well, we got some light from the candle. So it's true. You left the Libra because you regretted what you had done.
Regret? No, Qalian had regrets, yes, but Nylock isn't worthy of these feelings anymore. Regret is a pure feeling, as is absolution, but Nylock doesn't deserve purity.
Jeez.
So he hates. He hates himself. Hates his pathetic existence. Hates himself for all the suffering his old skin brought upon the world.
Stop talking about yourself in the third person, even as Nalak. That's really annoying. According to Tannison's biography, the Libra kills anyone who tries to desert. Why are you still alive, Qalian?
I told you! Because Nylak buried his old skin! The Libra doesn't care about Nylak. Why should they? He's vermin!
Why did you do it? Why did you order the murder of those girls?
Why? Because the decrees demanded it, and the decrees don't lie! They never did, and they never will.
So you actually still believe this nonsense? That those girls would have given birth to monsters? Is that what it is? I didn't take that from what, not him, the other guy. That they would have given birth to monsters. I don't think he told me that. He said we would never know why. But somehow I asking him that you still believe this nonsense that the girls would have given birth to monsters.
Aren't you listening? The decrees don't lie. Those little flowers had to die because if they had not, something terrible would have happened. Qalian knew, Nylak still knows, but still it broke him. All their pain, their tears, their suffering, their screams. It was too much to bear, even for him.
So why do you have to, like, gouge their eyes out first? Or did you do that afterwards? But how did you know? How did you know that these girls would have given birth to monsters? How did I even know?
The decrees never lie.
You said that. Getting repetitive here. Either way, we're here for a reason. We're looking for the lost pages.
Pages? Nalak doesn't know what you mean. Now, please, go. Nalak is tired and needs to sleep.
All right.
Nalak's gonna get strangled to death.
Rephrase my friend's words. You stop playing confused oracle and fucking tell us what we want to know now. And then maybe, just maybe, we'll let you live. Are we clear?
But Nalak just...
Are we clear?
You better say you're clear.
Yes. Yes, sir. Nalak understands. Please forgive him. So, the pages. Yes, of course, the pages. Nalak remembers. Qalian tore
Funny.
Them from Tannerson's book before the world could see them.
Blazes. What's all this talk about Nalak and Qalian? You are Qalian.
No! I told you! So why are you not listening? Qalian is dead! Don't you understand? He's dead, and Nylock buried him! Oh, no. He's sorry. Please don't hurt him. He will not raise his voice again.
Look at him. He's gone completely insane. I'm guessing all this Nalak talk is a way for his brain to cope with the guilt.
Yeah.
He's created a new persona without all the blood on his hands.
What's he so sure?
That is, unless he's lying.
What? Why? Why should Nylock lie? What? Why? Why should Nylock lie?
Okay, skipping. The record's skipping. How long have you lived down here, anyway?
How long? Years? Decades? He doesn't know. Qalian had a sense of time. Nalak doesn't.
How convenient. Well, then show us where these pages are.
Yes. Yes, of course. But tell me, what do you want with them? You won't be able to read them.
I'm going to shove them up your butthole. That's what I want with them. Why wouldn't we want to read them? Why wouldn't we read them?
Because they're written in the language of the Libra. Even Qalian couldn't read a single word of them.
Well, couldn't we? Then how was Tannerson even able to write them?
Isn't it obvious? Because something else guided Tannerson's hand when he wrote them.
That right. Well, I don't care. You lead us to the place where you buried them. And you'll do it now, Qalian.
Nalok doesn't have a choice, does he? All right, he will do as you demand.
Neither of you have a choice.
The pages, he buried them together with his old skin. He can show you the pages.
Your old
but
skin?
But tell him, my dam. If he shows you the pages, could you... Well, Nalok is hungry, Nalok is thirsty, and he has no more coin.
Of course not. I'll think about it, if you show us the pages.
Yes, Nalok understands. Good. Come, follow.
You dislike it. Too damn bad. Guess he wanted the threatening option.
My sir, Nalok has a question.
What?
Your face. You seem familiar. Are you certain that you have never met Nalok before?
How would I know? Maybe.
Can't get through. Okay. And a tar pit, huh?
This is the way to the tar pit. Are you sure that's where we're supposed to be going? I warn you, if this is a trap...
It's not, my sir. Nalok is vermin, but he knows when he has to obey. You can trust him.
I won't.
Wait.
Fine.
I'm switching that. Never mind, here we go. Walking very slow all of a sudden.
War. After all these centuries. That's just plain crazy.
In here? Yeah. It's not leading us to the blind miner, is he? Well, there's two places that I think I haven't gone down there, or maybe just one. Officially.
Hold it right there, old man. Where do you think you're going? You're a little too old for digging.
He belongs to us. We're acting under the Father's orders.
Brother, Wrath, from ashes to blood, from blood to liberation. I didn't recognize you. Forgive me.
Brother Wrath?
From ashes to blood, from blood to liberation. Let us through.
Of course. Father's blessings.
Father's blessings. Keep going, scum.
Yes, of course.
Yeah, I was hoping you were talking to him. What does this say now? Qalian's last smile. Qalian appeared to be a human wreck. He calls himself Nalok and lives in a shack in the Undercity as a beggar. Tharael was right. It seems that Qalian knows about the lost pages. He buried them together with his old self, which... I don't know what we're going to find there. His old self... We managed to convince him to lead us to the grave. Now, we're not going to find his body there unless he killed somebody. And then, try to convince everybody that was Qalian. Well, this is fun because it's never... This is always janky. Oh, we didn't actually write it down. Where are you going? I think it's down here we haven't gone, actually. Yeah. I think so. There's one of these places down there we ended up turning back and leaving because it was just very dangerous. Abandoned shaft. Yeah, this is it. We have not fully explored this.
Yes, we're here. This is where he buried the pages.
The deserted tunnels.
You should be wary. There's a lot of lowlifes down here. Yes. Certainly is. Cutthroats.
Enemy.
Level 46, nice. Gotta give it to Mana. Where's the other dead person? Oh. So this one, and then this one. Oh! I'm hitting the rail there. Ow! Alright, there's more trouble here. Excellent. The music's back, too. I know someone had mentioned the music was gone. The music is back. If I can, I already actually have it. Give me a good amount back. Alright, you guys took care of that. Sunborn Axe? Doesn't appear to have any magical qualities to it. Yeah, we got turned back. The enemies in here are just too great. Quite a long time since I've been in here. Wild Mage. Defense Robe. It's light. I can sell it.
There. Back there. That's where he buried his old skin.
These, my sir. You need to just take these last few steps.
What else did you kill?
Can't.
I heard a...
You just can't.
Is this a trap?
What? No. No, of course not.
I'll just take a cheese.
Just... Nalok can't! Don't you understand? To see him after all this time... No, kill Nalok if you don't believe him, but he will stay.
Fine. You go on ahead.
Find Nalok's buried memories with Tharael. Are you leaving, or just... All right, so which way? This way.
Skeleton. I'm not seeing anything.
It's there. I am gonna look around though. See if there's anything else. Nope. Found it. Oh, we need a shovel, don't we? It's like right there where my ghost is standing. Can't equip. So we normally click on it, I think. It was like right here. Wasn't it? Alright, I'm not seeing it. Am I supposed to do something? It looked like it was under these floorboards. We follow Qalian deep into the tar pit, a hostile place swarming with bandits. The pages must be around here somewhere. Search the shaft for an old skeleton. So maybe it's not under the floorboards? He keeps taking his sword out and putting it away. Oh, we had to dig. Wait. Oh! Call him.
Let me see.
Get over here, and you'll see. I can't really... Oh, that's it! Back there. The pointer was there. Threw me off.
Yeah. Well, that looks promising. Then I guess we need to dig. Come help me.
I have a shovel.
Here we go. This must be it.
Oh.
Pretty big. What the blazes did he put in there? What's that smell?
We're gonna get attacked, aren't we, once we open this thing? It's not my shovel, is it? No, I still have mine. You want some help with that?
What the? Oh, shit!
What? Whose body is that?
Well, good question. You want to know what I think? This is probably some poor sod that crossed this lunatic's path at the wrong time. So we put him right into the crate with the pages. Bloody son of a whore.
Hmm. Even if that's true, why should he go to the trouble of burying him? He could have just left him here.
Oh, fuck if I know. We're talking about a man who murdered 10 girls in cold blood because his cult ordered him to do it.
True.
I think you'd be well advised to stop trying to apply logic to his thinking.
I always try, you know. Either way, I think we've found the pages.
Right you are. Come on. You take them.
Take the last page. Alright. Bundle. Oh, we've also got a... Can you move this? There's other stuff in there. 34, nothing great. Oh, ancient mask? A blueprint of Kalian's last smile. And a bundle of lost pages. Let me take a look at this thing. A mask? And it's in Ancient Mask. Well, I guess we could sell it. It's not worth much, but... And a blueprint for Last Smile, isn't... That's Euro's Last Words. So we have Euro's Last Words and Kalian's Last Smile. I don't know if it always looks like this. I mean, it looks like it would be a helmet, but I don't know if that's just a default image or what. And then the bundle of lost pages.
Got them? Alright. Back to Qalian.
It's Qalian. Huh. I cannot read them. Alright. Let me guess, something happened to Qalian. Or he's gonna turn on us, either way. He's still here. We found them!
Get up, scum.
Ah, my sir.
You found what you were looking for, didn't you? He can tell by your eyes.
We found the pages and something else. Whose corpse is in that chest?
What? But he told you, didn't he? It's Qalian.
It's impossible.
Nalak buried him.
So you're seriously trying to tell us that that corpse over there is your old self?
Yes. He said it before, didn't he? Qalian couldn't continue to live in this shell after what he did, so he shed it and gave birth to Nalak.
What?
And Nalak buried him, together with the memories.
Alright, you've convinced me. You've gone completely insane.
You don't believe him. You think Nalak is lying.
You can't give birth to
the truth. The simple truth. You two, more than anyone else, should understand.
Sure.
You put his brain in someone else's body?
Oh. And now it's time for you to pay for your crimes, Qalian. It's been long overdue.
Oh, are you gonna kill him now?
What? But you'd spare him if he'd show you the pages!
We said that we would think about it. And guess what? I did. You're a murderer, Qalian. And you've killed more people than I can count.
He's gonna want me to kill
men,
him.
Women and children. And you know what? This whole act about how remorseful you are. I'm not buying it. Yes, you drank your bloody brains into oblivion, but ultimately, the only one you truly pity is yourself.
Well, you're looking at me and saying that. He's not gonna like either of these. What good would killing him do? It won't bring his victims back to life.
What? And to you, that's all that matters. If we let him live, even as a stinking beggar, we spit on the graves of those 10 girls, as well as on everyone else this piece of shit has butchered.
He's got a point.
This is about justice. I thought you'd be bright enough to understand that.
Yeah, you're right. Alright, let's end this. I take no joy in it, but let's end this.
Yes. Any last words?
Letho.
What?
By the name of the sun, you were in the refuge orphanage, you and your friend, Letho!
He knows you?
What do you know about the refuge?
Letho?
Back then, before the flesh maggot plague, when Nalak was still strong, the Kyranian woman who ran the orphanage gave him work. Don't you remember? He carried crates, he cleaned the floor, he cooked.
That was you? Uncle Nalak?
Yes, that's what you called him. Uncle Nalak. By the Guardians, it's been so long. But he remembers it all now. You and your friend, you were inseparable. Until...
You're right. I do remember.
What?
You were there when they took us.
Oh.
Worse, you helped them. What did she pay you, that old cunt? Huh? Carrying crates? Selling children to the Rolada? All the same, isn't it?
Wow.
No, what? Nalak doesn't understand. He only...
Let's go.
Oh, you're sparing him? Wait, you knew him?
Yeah. His face seemed familiar, but I just couldn't place him.
So he worked in that orphanage you grew up in, the refuge.
Yeah. We called him Uncle Nalak.
Yeah, I heard.
Shagun, the matron, gave him work as a gopher. He wasn't as much of a wreck back then. Can you believe it? A former serial killer working in an orphanage. Apparently the old cunt liked to surround herself with people as rotten as she was.
Huh. And who is this Letho Qalian mentioned? That's you?
It doesn't matter.
It's you. You think Qalian helped the Ralaim with the kidnappings?
I know it. He'd been there the night it happened. One of us, Wilma, she refused to go. She screamed and kicked. But Nalak held her while one of the father's voices gave her a sleeping potion. That fucking piece of shit.
And you still want to spare him now, even finding that out? What now?
Well, as I said, we're done here. Next, we need to bring the pages to the first seer, which will, hopefully, encourage him to consider you as a mercenary for the expedition. But we'll see. Before we do that, though, we need to discuss a couple of things. We cannot afford a single mistake if we want this to work. Meet me in my hideout tomorrow morning, all right? There's a small abandoned warehouse in the main cabin, right before the path up to the city. There's an old poster of the theater right next to the door. That's how you recognize it. The dark corners of our minds.
Fair enough. Until then.
Until then.
So you decided not to spare him. I can't even ask about that. Wait for a day to give Tharael time to prepare himself. I don't know why he spared you. But you killed all those girls. And then you helped afterwards as Nalak drugged these poor kids to be used by the father for their twisted experiments. I'm not sure why he decided to spare you. I, however, ended up having no such compunctions. Is that this whole... This is this whole place, isn't it? I think I might have been here recently. Yeah, I was. I was up in here, never mind. I remember all this. It pretty much ends here. And then plops out right where we started. Well, we gotta go find him now. Well, after a day. We're in the tar pit. Yeah, wait for a day to give Tharael time to prepare himself. To convince the Ralaim of my abilities as a mercenary, I have to bring them the lost pages of the Butcher. Well, in our shadows. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time in the next episode. A regular-sized episode next time. Thanks so much for watching. See you next time, and always, seek adventure.